If you've been to the movies lately or turned your TV on to your favorite TV show, chances are it was shot here in Georgia. The film industry is bringing billions of dollars to the Peach State. 41 NBC's Skylar Henry spoke to several key players on how the industry is impacting Middle Georgia and turning the state into a Hollywood South.
Lights.
I mean, we have a great tax incentive.
Camera.
We have diverse locations.
Beaches.
I mean, everything from the mountains to a major metropolitan city and the coastline.
Georgia is rapidly becoming the it town for movies and television. The superhero blockbuster Ant-Man was shot mostly at Pinewood Atlanta Studios in Fayette County and downtown Atlanta. The goal was to make the city look like San Francisco.
I think we're going to have continued growth in the infrastructure.
Lee Thomas, the deputy commissioner for the Georgia Film Commission, says the state is becoming a big draw for film crews in Hollywood.
Now everything's digital, everything's much faster. Incentives kind of, they narrow down the markets.
In the last 8 years, the film and TV industry has grown on its impact on the state's economy. In 2007, Thomas says the film industry brought in about $244 million for the state. Now that number's at more than $6 billion, supporting more than $1.6 billion in wages and creating more than 9,200 jobs. It's trickling down to Middle Georgia.
Macon really is a set. It's a movie set. They would have to build this in Hollywood because it doesn't really exist anywhere.
In the last 5 years, Macon has been home to several blockbusters. Jackie Robinson biopic, 42, used downtown and Luther Williams Field to look like a 1940s version of Brooklyn, New York.
It's up to us to market ourselves to get them to come here.
Need for Speed? The video game made action movie burned rubber around Cotton Avenue.
You're from Macon?
Yeah.
God, I love Macon.
We had so much fun in Georgia. It was such a great place to film. And, you know, they were so wonderful of opening up a lot of the streets for us to film in. Mm. And Macon was, I mean, what a town that we laid a lot of rubber down in.
Oh, yeah. We left skid marks all over.
Oh, yeah, they're still there.
I'm sure.
Well, I was hoping the rain was going to clean it for
yeah,
you.
Oh, yeah. Man. Is it really still there?
Some of it's still there.
Renting, you know, hotel rooms, going to dinner, hiring a caterer, paying for parking spaces, parking lots, renting buildings. So there's a lot of money that they leave when they come. Quite a lot.
It was cool, man. It reminds me of Cleveland.
Yeah.
As far as like that good old small town vibe, you know. And it was great. All the locals were great. A lot of action in the small town. We were ripping the city up. It was wild.
A big boost for the local economies in the state. Take Sonoy. What used to be a quiet small town is now the home for the dead. The Walking Dead.
Surviving together is all that matters.
They've gone from 6 storefronts to 47 storefronts since The Walking Dead has been there. The entire town is full.
The film industry is doing a lot more than just bringing jobs to the state. I'm actually standing inside a real prop from the TV show The Walking Dead that's filmed in Sonoy. A coffee shop retrofitted the entire restaurant to look like it came out of the TV show.
The city is now a tourist destination. While Georgia is seeing success, Thomas says there are still challenges for her and her 4-person staff. Competition is fierce from other states, including Louisiana and North Carolina.
It used to be we had a lot of time when we would drive around and scout all over the state. It's not that way anymore. We're very busy and we're a small group.
That's where events like the Macon Film Festival help give the state an added edge.
We bring all these filmmakers in from all over the world in hopes that they'll see the city and see it as a set for one of their potential films.
With the demand for filming in the state at an all-time high, Thomas and Governor Nathan Deal worry there isn't enough workforce to keep up. So they're exploring options for creating film academies that will teach students the ins and outs of working on a film crew across the state.
A partnership with the University System of Georgia and the Technical College System. It will be a certificate-based program. A lot of the tuition will be waived for the highest demand jobs that are out there.
I do see it correcting itself. We have to if our people want to work in the industry.
Qualified to stay in the race for the number one spot to film.
I'm hoping, you know, this Georgia Film Academy really turns out a great workforce. And I think that it will, you know, it'll end up being a race with L.A. and New York.
In Atlanta, Skylar Henry, 41 NBC News.
There are currently 42 films and TV shows in production across the state. Thomas says they're looking for an executive director for the proposed Film Academy, with hopes of starting the program by next spring.